Hello everyone, welcome to iLLPhoCorPhics. Now today we are starting another exciting iLLPhoCorPhics tutorial. Now today I'm gonna show you how can you create this awesome smoky effect in Photoshop, and I'm gonna show you all these things step by step so that you can learn and you can also create your own portrait into awesome smoky effect. So stay till the end of this tutorial and learn how can you create this awesome smoke effect. And if you're new, welcome. Make sure to subscribe and also press that bell icon, because I'm going to come up more exciting Adobe Photoshop tips, tricks and tutorials for you. So without any further ado, let's jump to our Photoshop. Now we're here, the magical world of Photoshop, and I'm going to use this beautiful image to show you how can I create this awesome smoky effect. So you can see this beautiful image. I just love this image. You can see how awesome way she's sitting in here. So to make this smoky effect, first of all, I'm going to make a duplicate layer of this layer. You can see this layer. Press Ctrl or Command J. You can also take it here and down to this little icon. Now we just create our copy layer. And the next thing, select the layer, go to the quick selection, and you can use pen tool if you want to use, but in this case I want to use quick selection because it's a beginner guide and most of the you I think you don't know how to use pen tool. So I'm going to use just quick selection to show you all the easiest way. Now just click and drag. You can see it will easily select our subject. Just how easily it's easy selected. Now the next thing, I'm going to refine the edges. Some of this area, you can see this here edge here, we need to select also the here edge. So to do that, just go to this, you can use a select and mouse in CC version. In this case I'm not going to use this one because I really don't love to use that much, but I'm going to use the older version of refine edge. If you're using CS6, you'll find it the refine edge in here, or if you're using CC version, just go to this selection and you can see the select and select mouse. Before click it here, press shift on your keyboard, then click. Now it will come up the older refine edge, then click and drag. You can see this one. Now you can see we just refining the edges. Just click and drag, it will automatically select your all the here so that you can use your own portrait tool. Like I just, you can see this one, it will not be 100% perfect because I want to select this area perfectly because I'm going to work on that, so I need to be perfectly selected. But in this case you can remain with your default. If you don't want to use, you can easily do that. Now go to this output, select output as at default, then hit OK. Then now the next thing, we need to press Ctrl or Command J because we need to make a selection into another layer. Press Ctrl or Command J, you can see the layer mask is only make a layer with this model, other one is not selected. Now invisible this one, come up to this layer and go to, you can Ctrl or Command in your keyboard, then click on this layer icon. We need to select the model again. Now the next thing, we need to remove this model from our image. To remove the model from our image, first what I need to do, we need to just go to this selection and modify and then expand, because we need to expand our selection to remove this area. Now in this case I'm going to use 250 pixel in you. If your image is too much high, you can use this, and if your image is a little bit small, you can use as your default. Now hit OK. Now you can see just selected. The next thing, what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove this one. To remove this one, just go to the edit, fill, and select the container, not any other, this just container, and hit OK. Now we just removed our model. You can see it's removed. Now the next step we need to do, we need to refine the edge. This area we need to remove also. Just press Ctrl or Command to D to deselect this selection from the image, then go to this spot healing brush tool, take the spot healing brush tool and make us a little bit bigger, and just click and drag. You can see it just selecting. Now the next thing, next step we need to go this in this layer and visible this one. Now make a duplicate layer on this two model. Just press Ctrl or Command D, DJ to make a duplicate layer, and then invisible the first one, come up the second one, select this one, go to this filter and liquify. You can see the liquify, click it here. Now it will come up the liquify. Now just go to this handy tool, you can see this one, and select the forward wrap tool and make the brushes a little bit bigger around, something like that, and it's okay. Now go out of here and click and drag. You can see it's making this one a little bit bigger. Just make the same thing, do the same thing here, and just click and drag. Now we just done the next thing, just hit OK, remain with the default, don't touch anything because we don't want to touch anything of that. So just go to this one and hit OK. Now you can see it's come up this one. Now it's looking kind of weird what we done, so don't worry because we're going to work on this one. Now the next thing, you need to apply the layer mask on this one because we need to remove this area and create our smoke on that, and also the distort effect. To do that, just press ultra option and then click on the layer mask. You can see this one and click it. It will remove this one and visible the model of here. Now we just remove this area because we use a inverse layer mask on that. You can see the layer mask is totally black, so it's not showing anything. The next thing, create another one. Just press Ctrl or Command J to duplicate this one. Select the layer mask. This same this the layer mask, and we need to apply our smoke. Before apply the smoke, we need to do some step what I need to first do, but I didn't do that, and because I want to show you the problems of some of the problem you will face, so you need to know how can you solve this one. Just first, you can see the smoke size. If I go to the brush and take the brush, and you can see it's adjusting not more than like that. You can see the brush size is not making bigger than this size, so this one is not going to affect because we need to apply our smoke all over this one, so we cannot work on that. So do that, just make the brush a little bit smaller, and this okay. Go to this image and image size. We need to remain the image size because you can see it's 7360 pixel width image, so we need to make this as a little bit smaller, but we're going to remain the resolution. Just press any kind of as you like to, in this case 2225, and I think this is perfect, and hit OK. Just go to this one, preserve details to automatic, don't use this one, just automatic, and hit OK. Now okay, just come out the press Ctrl or Command 0 to fit this one with your canvas. Just okay, now you can see you can make us a little bit more bigger than usually it is, so we're going to work on that. So this way I just want to show you, and I think you will not find this tip on anywhere. If you're working on your brush size, first thing you need to do, make your image size smaller than it is. So the next thing, just go to this image, take the brush and go the brush setting. You can see the brush setting is my is here. If you don't find this brush and brush setting, just go to the Windows and select the brush setting and also the brushes, and select the brush, these two. You can see this one, the brush setting and also the brush setting and also the brushes. So select this one. Now come up the down here, you can see I have lots of brush because I already downloaded many of them. If you want this brush, I will put the link all the brush what I use in this is composite, and I'm going to put that so that you can download and you can also use your own image. So now you can see, go out here, what are the brush size, and I think I will come to use this brush. You can see this brush and it makes a little bit bigger, and yes, this brush I'm going to use. Now make the brush size here, you can see the setting, you can set this one as you like to use. If I go closer, you can see this one, and we're selecting the brush, this one, this layer mask, before clicking here and just click here. Now before do that, I need to show that just change the foreground color into white because we're bringing back the layer or colors, so that's why you need to change the foreground color white. Make the opacity 100%, and also brush hardness is always a default will on that. Now click, you can see it's bringing back, but it's bringing back the other side. We need to invert this one, we need to rotate this one. To do that, just control or command Z, or also you can do that in here, just rotate in here, and you can see, you know, it's rotated and rotated a little bit more like this one, and click here, you can see created. The next thing, just do the same thing and apply as you like to use. Just rotate this one and apply your brush on this area, and I'm going to use this true if I this one and also this one. You can see this one, it's a little bit, make a little bit bigger and change it angle into 180, and this is great. Now apply this one. You can see we are going to use this true brush to create our smoke. Just take your time and apply the brush on your image. Now we just done our, we just add our smoke into the image. The next thing, we need to create another smoky effect on the model so that it look kind of similar composite on the smoke. To do that, just select this model and apply layer mask. This time we're not going to apply the invert layer mask, just click here, it will add the white layer mask on this one. Now take the brush, what is the before one, and this is the one, and select this one a little bit bigger, make a little bit bigger, and change the angle over like that, and you can see we need to change the foreground color into black and remove this area and also this area. Then select this one and make it a little bit bigger, and this thing is perfectly done. And apply some of the rain here also, do the same thing and just remove this area. Now we are pretty much done in this case. You can see we just done, and I think it's smaller, just a little bit bigger here, and apply this one is like this one, and this is great. Now we can see some of these edges remain on this area, so we need to remove also this one. Go down and take this soft light brush and make it a little bit bigger and make the opacity around 50, something like that, and remove this area. You can see, and this is perfectly done, and I think it's perfectly okay. Now we just created our smoky effect into the image. It's looking some of this way. Now we need to create a distort effect so that it's look more awesome. To do that, just go to this one. You can see this layer, we just make a this layer, select the layer mask, make the foreground color white, and take this brush, this one. And if you want this brush, I will put the link also, that's one. Now make a little brush a little bit bigger, you can see. So that's why I make this image a little bit smaller than usually it is. Now click here, double click on here, also click another one. Now it's okay. Now change the angle here. From here we're going to use only the drops of this one image, make invisible this one, and apply a little bit here, not here, just okay. Now change the angle of this one and change the angle like this one, and I think this is perfect, and this is great. It's awesome, and I really love this one. Now we can see we just created our one. Go to the move tool and we are done. Now if you take your time and if you work on that, it's gonna looks more awesome. But in this case, I want to add some of the more effect to make this image more dramatic, and in this case I'm happy with that, but I would like to add some of the effect on that. Just select this one, the image, and go to the adjustment layer, go to the color mockup, and use another color mockup. What are the color mockup you like to use in your own portrait? And how about this one? It's not going to look okay, and I think this is okay. Candy light is perfect. Now decrease the opacity around 50, and under the 50, whatever this one, and this is great. And we just done it. Now we just make our image as we want, and we just create our awesome smoke effect. If you take your time and create this one, it's gonna look awesome. So see the before one and the after one. This is the before one And this is the Afron, which has created our awesome smoke effect in Photoshop. And I'll show you all the things step by step. So take your time and make your own smoky effect. And again, if you want to practice this image, you can also use this image for your practice. Just check the link in the description, and I also put the brush, all the brushes you want in the link. So I hope this tutorial helps you, and I hope that you like this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, hit that like button. If you don't like it, you can also click that dislike button, and I don't think that you don't like it. And if you like this tutorial, if you learn from this tutorial something, and if you want to learn more about Photoshop, just make sure to subscribe my channel and also press that bell icon. You can also check out my other tutorials in my channels. I hope that you like this tutorial. And what do you think about my tutorial? Just leave it in the comment section. I want to know what you think about my tutorials. And you can also share this tutorial with your friend so that I can grow up. Please guys, show love and support me to grow with my channels. And you can also follow me on Twitter and Facebook. Check the link in the description. You can follow me on that. Just go and follow my channels in Facebook, and also, and you can also follow me in Twitter, Facebook. Just check the link in the description. And that's for you today, and I see you in the next tutorial. Till then, bye. And the most important thing, guys, I always say to you, keep learning.